yeah, I don't know that, Cyrus. I want to say yes, because that's how it would work for some other games. All right, what are we playing against? We have a Coyote. Okay, we have a couple different stuff coming up. We need stuff that's either going to soak up the hit. I think we play the Stoat. Fine. Don't fine me. Rude. All right, let's try it. All right, it's fine. We're doing great. All right, so we're going to want to bring this out. All right, put it there, and then we're going to bring the ant out and put it there. So that will be able to kill that. So we could technically sacrifice it to put this out, which would do the same thing. Then we get that ant back in hand. We should do that, actually, because we get a lot of those tokens now. I think that's a move. I think that's a play. Alright, so we should draw a card now. So strange, why can't I remember his name? I believe I lost some of my memory in the flash. Okay. Now what we could do is that we want to kill that, so what we'll do is bring that, sacrifice that, put that over there, and then we can put this here because we have plenty of those tokens. Good play. Thank you. We're winning now. We should draw another card. Cage Wolf. Okay, we could do this, but there's no benefit for the Cage Wolf. Like, unless we have a way to kind of get this out, I don't want to sacrifice anything, so we'll just keep hitting them. I guess let's draw a card. You have it here, I surrender. Yeah, oh, I didn't have to do it like that, though. Let's draw another card. Place this here. Maybe we do these, we get more. Darkness take me, all right. See, then we get some extras. How brutal of you. You dealt me more damage than you needed to win. However, in my game, such feats are rewarded. There resides a tooth to keep for extra damage dealt. The trapper may be interested in your spoilers. Okay, so it was worth it, so I shouldn't have let him, like, surrender to me. Okay, we have still have a lot of items. I haven't used any of them. The campfire allows me to buff a card. This allows me to sacrifice for a different ability. So let's see what we get from here. The Tragic Rat King, when tangled bodies become corpses, you will gain 4 bones. This gives me 4 bones? Is that what that means? Hold up. There it is. When a card brain the surgeon dies, 4 bones are 1 instead of 1. We don't really need that. With the rat combo, we're doing pretty good. If ever banished, it's playing cause. Strike both to the left and right. Okay, that's cool, I guess. The adder is back. The adder is a great card. This allows us to do a lot of damage, though. We don't really need more bones. In fact, I actually would like more bones cards. Also, notice that there's... Oh, that's how we look at our deck. Okay. Ooh, that's a tough play. Oh, that's a, so it's like a tribal. So that's a reptilian. That's, I have no idea what that little symbol up there looks like. But you see that has a weird symbol. That's a reptilian. That's a weird symbol. That's a weird symbol. So I guess it's just like other bugs, whatever. Okay, we're learning stuff. Can I look around? Oh, I don't know! Ah! Okay, there's been more situations where I feel like I want more damage being dealt to the side, so let's go for that one. Okay. Now, what we could sacrifice, or we can make something stronger. Sacrificing does thin out the deck to give me exactly what I want. I don't know what that is, though. I don't think we've met that. So I'm kind of tempted to go that route. So let's go that route. I want to see what it is. I'm curious. Group is starving. The survivalist stood around a dying campfire. There is room for a creature around the fire. The warmth will enhance its health, said another. Lizard said nothing at all, but could not stop licking their lips. So it's going to increase my health by 2. No way. Oh. Hmm. Maybe the praying mantis having a lot of health would be good? They don't want me to pick them, apparently. And the possum having extra health doesn't really matter to me. I think the praying mantis getting extra health would be good. Because it will last longer then. The health of the mantis was enhanced by the warmth. So once it was beginning pulling a knife from their pocket, you withdrew. I feel like those hunters are going to come get me at some point. Alright, let's see what this is. Oh, it's a fight. Okay, so that makes them all have Flyer, Cody, okay, cool. And I guess we'll sacrifice that. I think that's the play. Okay, so it did damage to me. Okay, we gotta panic a little bit. So I get, I'm not gonna be able to do anything to them. So that was a misplay. That was a huge misplay. Because I'm not gonna be able to block that. And that was the card I needed to block with. Ant Queen, huh? Alright. We need to use this. Let's go ahead and get rid of that card. Won't matter because it's gonna fly over me anyways. But we need to put, I guess, that there. Then we can put the skink here. So that'll at least block that. Then we gotta chill, I suppose. Do I want to pull a tooth out? I guess. To give myself more time. Oh, it's got flying. Oh, I forgot. Okay, we need to bust stuff out. Power numbers, Ant Creed. I can't play that though. The Cage Wolf doesn't do anything for me. So we lose this one. Oh, we killed it? Okay, there was a lot of misplays in that one. I always forget that when they have flying, I can only block it with like something like the Toad. But if they, when attacking, I hit them no matter what. Don't how disappointing me. That was a tough fight. All right, this is another new one. You must make a different kind of choice. Choose not a specific beast, but decide the cost that you wish to pay. Oh, like how much do I want the cost for the card to be? I mean, that three cost card has got to be good, right? I'm kind of curious. A grizzly. The monstrous grizzly, its form speaks enough for its efficiency. A random card with a cost of three. What were you expecting? I don't know, but I guess I'm cool with it. A massive deck, though. So a campfire or a bag. We don't have any more items, so I guess the bag is the play. Actually, turn or flight. Let's take the... They skip a turn. Some bone tokens for a rainy night. Or the scissor. Okay, so this gives me bones? Which might be okay, but this removes a card too. I mean, removal is always going to be what I'm going to choose. I think I'll take the bones, I guess, at that point. Alright, time to fight the Prospector again with one life. We gotta beat him twice. Oh, alright. An incessant clank, clank, clanking reverberated between your ears. The path ahead was blocked by a grotesque figure. Lovely! It was a Prospector. Yeehaw! We got a random boulder, too. Prospector's boss again. Alright, we got a Cody and a pack mule. Okay. I can start the game off now, like strong, that might be the play. We'll move that there. And then we just, I guess I could get a creature out now, or I can wait. I think we'll wait. Yep, you passed. Sweet. Let's draw a squirrel. Go ahead and play the squirrel there. And that's got two, and this is a threer, so. Wait, hold up. I don't, can I change that back? Oh, wait, what is this? Last save Domenico. Okay, I actually made a mistake. Alright, hopefully... Oh, it did have a damage on it. Okay, maybe that wouldn't have been a mistake. We could have left it there. Oh well. Can I use that to... There are no cards. Okay. Can't cut anything yet. Okay, Cody Cub. Let's play the squirrel here. We'll play the work again there. So now that makes them all stronger. Then we could do the bones, but there's no need to. And we're gonna go pretty crazy with all those ants. I think we're fine with this, because then I can put the stoat out. Keep me alive. Okay, you got it. Wolf is big, they're swinging at me, there goes that, that's dead. Draw a card, I got a wolf, hey? I mean, how much damage do they have? We have enough to win right now, don't we? I think we do. Oh, that's right, it's only gonna be one candle though. I forgot about that. There's gold in them cards. Oh, that's right, I forgot they're gonna do that. Alright. Great. Need something good. The caged wolf. That caged wolf, he hit that for a reason. Card seems useless, but I think it's more to it. Okay, so I should play the caged wolf, is what they're telling me. Shall we? Okay, that's good there. And then I gotta wait for those to be used, I guess? I can't sacrifice them. Get him! Okay, alright. That's fine. To do one damage, I need better cards. There's the Mantis. The Mantis is pretty great. I could do this and kill... I think we killed that. Yeah, I think we killed that. So let's do this, kill that card. Sacrifice that and put that there instead, which is going to do a damage there, but I don't get affected by it. Like a judge? Yeah, I feel that too. Okay, not great, but not, that's going to be fine. Got another worker ant, which doesn't really help me right now, but we'll kill both of them. We'll kill that. Oh, don't freak out on me. But if I sacrifice that, then I can put the ant down. But that's gonna kill them both anyway, so I think we're chilling? Yeah, I think we're chilling. It's got death touch, so that sucks a little bit. But what we can do is we can play the squirrel. We can play that there, it doesn't really matter. Then what we can do is just play that right here instead, and that's gonna kill that guy. We got a wolf to worry about, and then what we do is we play this here, then we can scrap both of these to put a wolf there. Can't play that yet, but we will soon. What did I get? Oh, that's huge! Dag dammit, it's my mule! Mine now. Alright, we got a rattler. I won't let him before you draw a new one. Oh, that's fair. So we got a lot of stuff to play now. I think we just want cards we can throw away. So now this can go here, and we're chilling. elk that's gonna get better later on. We got another, we need to sacrifice, so we'll do the squirrel to go here. I mean, I guess putting the ants fine. We're kicking your, so we, it's good thing we went for the mule that time. That was almost a misplay. All right, and then from there, I guess let's draw a card. We got a pussum! And I can't get rid of that? That's unfortunate. These only do a little bit of damage. And that's gonna get better over time, so I guess we'll put that there. All right, and I guess we'll swing. I think we win off of that, though. Allow me to light your kindles once more. I won't be killing you quite yet. Oh, okay. So defeating the boss allows you to progress further. You're the first in a while to overcome a boss. Of course I am. As a reward, you're granted an opportunity to select a rare card. Ooh, choose carefully. Ouroboros. Isn't this like a reference to the Norse mythology? So it's a 1-1 for 2. Eternal Serpent, Death Strings it forever. Oh, it gets stronger over time. Down Inspiring Gek, perhaps you can find a use for it. It doesn't cost anything, so it's just a 1 for 1. The level of the Brutish Strength needs no explanation. Yeah, that's crazy. So this, I will be able to play for free and just get more stuff to play around with. This one's going to get stronger apparently over time, but does still cost 2. This costs 4, but I already have a really big card, so I actually think the Gek is what you pick here. With the sound of the Prosperous Pick has still ringing in your ears, you carried onwards. Oh. The rank smell of rot and mold permeated the humid air. Alright, so progress, am I right? Alright, this is kind of cool. I'm still playing, don't worry. I'm going to keep going for a little bit. But what do you guys think? Kind of fun, right? It's a little weird. I mean, I could get up, right? Every step forward was answered by some nearby slip or slither. I mean, I probably can. I think I have to wait for this one. But yeah, the card management is there. The roguelike's a little weird. I'm still finding new symbols to play around with. I haven't beaten this one, but that seems like a tough fight. So we're going to have to figure that out. But I hope you all enjoyed this. Thanks for hanging out. Every step forward was answered by some nearby slip or slither. You tread cautiously into the wetlands. I can get up though, right? And we haven't had that been able to happen. Can't interact with those. I wish I could figure out what this 100% meant. The smoke still hasn't changed. Raining right now. I'll let you use that, but not now. Okay. What up? Alright, well, I guess we'll keep playing. I'm supposing. I was hoping to see if, like, if I could go around and, like, figure out any puzzle stuff, but I guess not. Alright, so we'll check out this place. There's a bag so I can get more items. These bones have not been useful. I wish I could get, we might just get rid of that if I can. This is gonna power up, but it also gives me, I guess, an elite, I'm assuming, because I've played Slay the Spire, so I've played games similar to these concepts that have these kind of things. Thanks for the follow, appreciate that. So Dark Gamer. I'm just trying to figure this game. I've never played this before, so I'm figuring stuff out. What is the character there for? What is the character there for? This is to mark me. This is just for when I'm ever playing, I can get tokens for. I don't know what that's going to be. We found a whole bunch of stuff already. I like the ants. The ants are pretty good. I guess I need to unleash the cage wolf at some point. We need to play that. Oh look, there's some extra the teeth and stones. Alright, well, let's just press on, I guess. We'll figure it out as we go along. You arrived at the inky black mouth of a cave. A strange beast lurked within. It spoke, "Pass one of my trials, and I will be yours," in a raspy voice. Three creatures will be drawn from your deck. This will decide success or failure. So again, but first you will choose a trial. Trial blood. The three drawn cards must cost at least 4 blood combined to pass. Trial bones. The three drawn cards must be the cost at least 5 bones to pass. Or the trial of wisdom. The three drawings must have at least 3 sigils among them to pass. So I have 4 cards and they all have to give me enough blood. 3 cards and they all have to give me 3 different symbols or 5 bones. I don't have a lot of bones, so I don't want to do that one. I do have some blood. Like a couple of ones and twos. I think I have a lot more cards with symbols though, so I think we go for that one. Let the trial of wisdom begin. Alright. There we go. 1 from the ant queen, 1 from the bat, and 1 from the bullfrog. You have passed the trial. I'm a champion! The beast revealed itself. It was... Oh, I get to pick it. A river otter. What? A warren. So bunny rabbits or a bat. But they... So this is an extra symbol. And it has like a patch on it. I don't know what some of those mean. Let's take a look real quick. So we know the flyer, and that's the stinky one, so it's gonna make him a little less stronger. So that could be good. That might be the pick. Okay, we're moving, we're going, we're finding, we're doing. Alright, when a card bearing the symbol is played, a rabbit is created in your hand. A rabbit is defined as 0 power to 1 health, so it doesn't cost anything. And then this can attack both sides, but it doesn't really help me since it has no power to begin with. Now, I could potentially buff that, but we already have the ants give me cards, so I don't, maybe that's not to play. What's the river? No. Mighty Leap. Repulsive. Did I pass it already? Oh, here we go. A card bearing the symbol submerges itself during its opponent's turn. While submerged, opposing creatures attacks its owner. Wait. While submerged, opposing creatures attack its owner directly. A card bearing the symbol submerges itself during its opponent's turn. While submerged, opposing creatures attack its owners directly. Wait, so does that make it to where... That seems good. Oh, okay, for some reason, I thought it was saying that they are attacked by me. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, no, that seems like a great card. I thought that it was going to have them attack themselves, but still, this is a good choice because I mean, I get pretty much instant removal all the time. This is not bad, especially for the 4 bones, and I have a little bit of bones to play with. I think this is the play. I think that's the card. The inhabited river otter joined your menagerie. All right, sweet. So I could get more items, or I could buff a creature. I think I'm gonna go that route. I'm gonna buff a creature. Yeah, with Death Touch. I like that I actually know some of the mechanics. The warm light of the campfire was a welcome sight. Through the 10 hungry eyes around it dampened the greeting. When a creature by the fire enhanced its power, said one. I think at one point they're gonna eat something. Pick something else, do what you must. Ooh, the mantis getting a little bit stronger wouldn't be terrible. Or I can give this one, which will do 2 and power. Then I get some more value overall. The mantis would be even stronger. I kind of like the mantis idea. I mean, the depth touch is nice, but I want to treat that as just straight up removal. I think we do the mantis again. Boom! Can we agree that seems like a great card? I think so too. I'm glad we're all syncing up together, everyone. Good job. And Dark Ape, you're more than welcome to ask questions or talk to me. I would appreciate no spoils if you don't mind. I'm assuming you play most of this game or know about this, so thanks for stopping by, just in case you're still hanging around. But everyone, keep it up. You're doing great. The survivors were right about the flames. They enhanced the creature's power. Spotting a few of the survivors drooling, you made a hasty retreat with your mantis. Yeah, we got out of there. All right, so we could fight up. I want to try this again. Ooh, that's different. That's an ant. So that means that they all will move over. Look, there's a third talking card somewhere around here. Personally, I hate the guy. Biggest killjoy ever. But he's the only one of us with a plan to get things back to normal. It's gotta be talking about the wolf. All right, what do we have here? A bee and a bee. So flying, and they're gonna move over. Okay. So it's going to kill that. This only does one damage, so that's actually great. So it's gonna hit my guy. But we're gonna— oh, that's right, I forgot it was gonna move on me. Alright, it's fine. Everything's fine. So we're gonna move that, we're gonna put that. Alright, they're gonna exchange spots. They would exchange spots, but that's fine. We'll do that. We'll sacrifice that. We'll move that there. You sure? I guess. To be honest with you. Not 100% sure, but we're doing it. Okay, a little scary. Okay, good. That's fine. That works out great. We should probably draw a card. So I could sacrifice those two. And attack both as well. Ooh, I think we're— because that's gonna give me two. I almost have enough for that. Oh, if I— okay, so here's a thought, but I'm gonna take a lot if I leave. Okay, I think I have to leave these here. And we're fine, we're doing okay. Okay, so that's gonna do damage, that's gonna kill that. We're still taking too much though. I think I draw a card and hope. Yes, perfect. That's exactly what we needed. So this can go here. I think we're fine on that. Took a damage, but we're chilling. We're doing great. So now I will play— okay, we need to draw a card. We'll do this one. The reason why is because what we're going to do is we're going to play this wolf. We're going to kill the working ant. We're going to kill the possum. The ant comes back to my hand. We'll play the wolf there, which will kill that. And then... yes, we'll play this here. We'll play the worker ant to replace it. There we go. I think we're doing stuff now. The next turn, I can even get more value. Because what we'll do is we'll play this here. And then what we can do is that once again we can play that there. That's a big old bear now. We can draw a card. Oh, cool! So we got the Gek, which will allow me to sacrifice to bring back. Or should we chill on that? I guess we can. I guess we can chill. All right. Maybe we could have done that a little differently, but we beat him. That's cool. I don't think we've ever beaten that before. Wait, that's it? We just beat it? We don't get anything? Do we just get a harder fight to get a harder fight? I think that probably means we get rid of a card. All right, well, we'll see what this is then. All right. Adder, Beehive. The invulnerable guy, when it's attacked, you will draw a bee. Huh. River Otter again. As Lucifer submerges itself during my turn. This gives me something. I still don't know what those are. I can go for a Death Toucher. The Smirch is not bad, but we're gonna be taking damage. This will give me more card draw to start playing stuff more. I'm kinda debating on that. I think we take that. Alright, let's see what we can get rid of. I'm assuming that's what this is gonna be. You come across some familiar stones, but there was something different. Intuited that the fate of the creature selected for this would not be pleasant. Stop this. So maybe I don't do the cage wolf, because that would be bad, I'm assuming. Sacrifice the Gek. what do I not need? I mean, the skink, probably? You task and started the skink. I did. However, the Lobomo was pleased by your sacrifice. Oh, we got a card back? Hey, Mnemonic, yo, maybe to check out this game. How's it going? It's weird. There's puzzles. I'll show you in a second. We're going through the roguelike part of it right now. A mere boon of the Bone Lord. A minor boon of the Bone Lord, excuse me. You will start each battle with one extra bone. That's lame. You shook off the viscera of the poor skink and carried onwards. Oh, I kind of feel bad now.